do or pursue sa in this partnership?
Let's start with Ian.
So, ayun po. Siguro expectation ko is may work, of course, diba? And I need to enhance my English speaking skills kasi syempre abroad yun. And masaya siya. Masaya siyang good problem, kumbaga sa akin. And it's part of my growth. So, nagpapasalamat po sa lahat and sa mga nandito po na sumubay mo.
Sa akin po ay based naman sa mga napanood natin kanila, their scenes, right? As I got to talk to them, I heard that they do a lot of action in Singapore. To shoot in a different country would be a dream come true. And yeah, I guess growth, yeah, you know, something different, something new. And I just want to shoot in Singapore. It sounds fun. Sounds fun.
It's fun. Maybe when you come over, we can shoot together.
Yeah, bro. We're gonna make a movie together.
Yeah. I think for me, I was here before for the DLM too, and I had a lot of fun on set. I think the atmosphere was amazing. But I know that the Philippines is known for their action and horror films. So I'm a huge action buff. I've been an athlete since I was a kid. And I think that high octane films will be right up my alley. So I'd love to star in an action film in the Philippines soon. For me, I think I would just love to learn, honestly, to learn from the people of the Philippines. And like I said earlier, I think my experience is that the Filipino people are very creative, very fun, and I've enjoyed working with them in Singapore because, I mean, we have Filipino crew as well in Singapore, and it's always such a great time, such a great environment to work with them. So I think for me, I would love to come here to learn from all the wonderful actors industry, and also I think for myself, I would just love to bring a Singaporean flavor, a Singaporean insight and perspective. Hopefully the Filipino market will, the audience will enjoy it. Hopefully you bring something fresh and we can all grow together.
Hi, Bo. Growing up, I've always watched a lot of action movies, villains and all that, and I know that Filipinos are very big on their action and horror, so definitely I would like want to star in those shows if possible and contribute to Filipinas TV. And I'm really looking forward to working in my home country because growing up my family has always been, why are you in Singapore? You should come to Philippines to film and, you know, do TV. I was like, am I God willing, and I'll be here. And eventually, thank you to BP Global and my manager TCP for bringing me here and having this opportunity to showcase my capabilities. And of course, I'm open to learning from each of my peers here. I met them just now. They're all wonderful people, warm, wonderful, and hardworking people. And I'm looking forward to learning a lot from them, having a lot of laughter, joy, and of course, creating good work.
Like Brian, I agree with the learning. The thing about doing a job or something you love is that you always want to learn and grow, and you want your mind to be fed information and new skills. So what I'm expecting from this collaboration, this partnership, is really to learn from my new co-actors, hopefully, and the culture of Singapore, and also to show the rest of the world to what we Filipinos can also bring to the table. Yeah, so I'm really looking forward to and very excited to be working with TCP and Virtual Playground together. So, yeah.
I've been sharing with everyone that I started playing basketball since I was 3, so like most of my life I've been doing the sport. And right now I'm navigating through this industry. I'm just trying to put myself out there, and the first project I did, I was very happy with it. I actually felt the same love I felt for basketball with acting. So right now, it doesn't really matter to me what the project is, as long as the opportunity is there for me to keep improving my craft and this whole new world I'm trying to live in and to thrive in. And I'm very happy that I'm doing it with the right set of people, with the best managers, and who are now partnering with another good agency would just have us in Singapore. So I'm very excited to travel as well and to just bring the fun into working. Thank you.
I think this collaboration is beautiful, opening us to the culture and lifestyle of Singapore. My first series was with Manopop, and as a Filipino Chinese, I think it was nice that the Filipino viewers were able to see the Chinese community that was not really spoken of here in the Philippines. And what more if we can see the community of Singaporeans and also the Chinese community there. I wish this collaboration could promote more awareness to the Filipinos to be more open and to expand their knowledge about the international stream, and not maybe only in Singapore, but also in Thailand and other countries, we may find more collaborations and bring more Filipino viewers to international ideas.
Thank you, congratulations.
Hi, I'm Tessa Momisharala from Manila. My question is for Reynold. I think both sides of the artists from Singapore and the Philippines are very lucky to have you in the group, because you're the one who'll be able to give them an insight into what it is to work in the Philippines and what it is to work in Singapore. So if there's anything you'd like to, if there's any advice you could give your fellow Singaporean artists, how they would do well working in the Philippines, and then tell your Filipino counterparts how they would do well working in Singapore, what would these be? Adjustments or, you know, any you know, like nitty-gritties that the two sides have in that are different, perhaps?
Wow, thank you. it's a great question. I think, because having worked in Singapore and the Philippines, the biggest difference I feel would be in terms of culture. Not to say that one is better than the other, it's just that the subtle differences that we have. So I've noticed when I flew here to the Philippines to film that the Filipinos are a lot more willing to have fun. Let's put it that way on set. So on set it's very lively, everyone's always joking, cracking jokes, laughing. But I think in Singapore it's slightly more systematic. So it's a bit more like, okay, we have to get this done by this and this and this. So I think that's the subtle difference that we have there. But in general, of course, filming on both sides are fun, and both sets of production crew and people working there are very professional. Yeah.
So your fellow Singaporeans can let their hair down a little bit working here, and then the Filipinos just kind of have to mind their time a little bit more.
I can say that. You said it not me.
From one another. I mean,
I'm sure. I've learned a lot from the Filipino crew, and of course I'm sure that my fellow Brian and David can pick up a lot as well, and my fellow Filipino colleagues can learn a lot from us as well. We have still all a lot to learn.
All right, yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
And thank you, Sir Charlie, again, and Sir Ken. Hi, hello there. We know that, you know, that your group has always really been focused on, you know, going international, and this is a major step in doing that, partnering with TCP. In the future, are you also looking, because it seems that you may be the first ones to, you know, partner up in Southeast Asia, are you hoping to do so for the other Southeast Asian nations and maybe, you know, become a really strong sort of force in entertainment in this side of the world?
Yeah, definitely. We're really looking for more partnerships with the different countries, because we feel that, you know, it's about time that we get recognized. We're being recognized internationally, but I think we can still be bigger, you know, and actually we're not just targeting Southeast Asia. We want to really grow as a global force in the entertainment business.
It's very exciting.
Hi, thanks for the question. Inside, yes, we are in talks with also our Thai partners as well as our Malaysian partners. But amongst all, the first country that I decided to come to and work on a press conference was the Philippines. And you can ask my staff, we're actually really in talks with a few different partners. But I think this country has given Reynold his career. He's given Reynold his boost. And I think, ironically, Singaporeans know Reynold through a Filipino production. I think that means a lot. I think this is something we want to give back. And that's why we specially flew here. We definitely will have other stops in Asia, Southeast Asia. But Filipino stop is our number one and only.
That's good to know. Does TCP stand for something?
Yes, it's called the Changing Point. But I think it's too long, so we decided to just shorten it by calling it TCP.
Alright.
Yes.
And then, as you know, Virtual Playground has quite a solid foundation in the Philippines, given, Ms. Rosell's Regal Films, one of the, the most established film companies in the Philippines. Is TCP also involved with production companies, or is it a talent management team to begin with?
I think we are just mainly a talent management agency, but we do partner with, in fact, all of the production houses in Singapore. And hopefully one day we can get good funding to work something out with Rico, Ms. Rosell. Cross-country collaboration is something that I'm really, really keen to work on. And hopefully we can, have all 8 of our stars appear in the show. That'd be cool.
Well, thank you for your appreciation of the Filipino talent.
Of course. In fact, my grandmother is Filipino. Yeah, so I'm quarter Filipino. Yes. And I think there was once he came over to Singapore. I think we brought him out for a meal. And then we got to know him, and then he told me about Sir Charlie. And then after that, we met Sir Charlie. But basically, long story short, I don't know how they did it, but I'd like to thank Ms. Rosell and Regal Films, because after talking for a while, they had the opportunity for Reynold to star in The Day I Love You. And The Day I Love You was such a hit that we were all taken back by surprise. We knew it was going to be a good show, but when the viewership came out, I think in total there are about more than 3 million, 4 million views on YouTube in total, and over 600-700 million views on TikTok. I think that was when we realized, maybe we should sit down and talk a partnership. And I think it's very special because both Singapore and the Philippines, we have a very strong relationship together. And I think this is the first time we see both sides bring our celebrities together. And I really hope that the Filipino media can continue to support the 8 of our stars. And likewise from Singapore, we continue to support you guys in any way possible. So hit us up if you need any help.
Thank you, sir. Are there specific projects we should watch out for now?
Well, right now, here in the Philippines, we're talking to Ms. Rosell about some projects, so we still have to find a place.
I think from our end, because happy to share that Reynold has just been named the ambassador for Puma in Singapore. So we are trying to bring over certain opportunities, first with social media related work for our 8 of our stars, including some of the fashion work. And I think for me, my aim is to make sure that the Singaporean viewers as well as the Filipino viewers get to see a different side of the Filipino stars that they've never seen before. And I also look forward to working with Sir Chuck and Sir Mark on the possible projects we could do in the Philippines.
Thank you very much.
How are the stars of Regal Films selected for this project? Because we all know that there are so many Regal beauties. Islamica, Shana. How did you get for this follow?
Yes, actually, you can even, based from the yung roster that we have, we check on who among the stars can really cross over. Those stars that has the skills and the marketability to actually capture also the hearts of not just Filipinos but other nations. So among all of the roster, of course, we know the capabilities of Sarah, of Miga, and then Rob also, and then our new ones in the entertainment industry, which is Christiana and Dylan. So definitely, if you've been with VP for the past events that we have, and I think you will agree with me that this 5 of the VP talents are the best to represent the Philippines to Singapore.